Hello and welcome back again. So in the previous video we were talking about some public property, private property, how we can access the private property and how we can expose them. On the same topic, let's talk about the module pattern, which is also providing the same thing. So consider this is a function, right? It's a plain function. We are writing a few things inside the function. Do your own stuff. And then we start creating the object of this person of function, right? This is the typical way of creating a functions and creating the object. But what about how can I access the variables I'm declaring here, which is a private, or the functions which I'm declaring here, something like this. So I'm creating a private functions or the public function, something like this. This is how I can create the public property, which can be accessed by the objects of these functions, and these are the private method, anonymous method, and the private property. How can I access them? Either way, just access this private property and return it from the public function. Okay, so this is a say hello method, right? You can call this private method directly from this. This is a local method, you can call it, and it will be accessible. So you can just from outside person object, you will call say hello, it indirectly calling the get data method of the private functions. Okay, so all these things need some pattern. So we can create a module pattern, something like this, where you have the private property, private variable, private functions, and being exposed. Those are being exposed by the public functions or by revealing pattern. Okay, consider this is a person object. I'm using if you block here, immediately invoke a function. You can write it without if you block also, then you need to call this function manually. First you need to create an object. It's like now a plain function. First create object of that function like this, and then call that method die. So this is the die is the method which we are revealing from here. This is what your function is returning, right? So I can call this using new person and then person.die, person object.die method. Person object.die method is actually accessing the private property, right? This is also a private function, but we are exposing it and we are revealing it. Either you can reveal it through the public function, something like this. This dot get status, and from here you can call this method die. Okay, and then reveal it this particular method. First of all, you can access this particular method directly on the object because you have bind this onto the this object. Okay. So no, not even need to return this particular piece of code. You can just good with this, right? And you can just call get status method there. Okay, and you're good. But revealing pattern gives you the advantage is you can create a multiple patterns here, like grow old. This is also a private property. Let's convert this into the object key or key value pairs. So now object, because this function is explicitly returning this, either you can return these private functions like this, or you can use the public functions to return the private or to call the private functions, right? This is the advantage of using it. Like person module, you can declare your private variables, private functions here, and then when you are returning something from this object, you can just return those functions who again calling the private functions. I mean, this is just a way of accessing the things. So let's make it as a revealing pattern inside a module pattern. So now you can just directly call person.die. because this itself will call the functions and give you this return object, so you can directly call die method on this. Okay, this is all about the public private properties in JavaScript functions.